Good morning, children. Welcome to online classes for 9th class. My name is K. Girija. I'm school assistant, social studies at Government High School, Rajendra Nagar, Khammam. I'm very thankful to our DEO sir and Khammam Suryapeta Social Studies Forum for giving this opportunity to me. So, children, today we discussed about our earth. You all know about our earth. You're all living on this earth only. So today in this topic we discuss about some areas of this lesson. The first one, how this earth was formed, and the next, grid system of our earth, latitudes and longitudes, and so many subtopics we discussed in this lesson. But now today we know about how our earth was formed and when was this formed. So today the first one on this earth, we call this earth our mother earth, because we are all living on this earth only. Not only ours, means not only human beings, microorganisms to human beings, means all the insects, plants, animals, and which are life on this earth, totally live on this earth. So this is called, we call this earth as mother earth. So this earth also evolved about 1 lakh years ago. So this evolution of earth also we discussed in latter part of this lesson. And this earth is known as, so much of resources are there in this earth. So much a house of resources, means in this interior part of the earth, so many minerals, so many metals, such types of which are useful to our industrial development, which are useful to our human lifestyle. These are all came from this earth only. So that is called only, our earth is known as the house of resources. So means so many types of resources are there on the earth. And also human also wanted to use it to this earth as his better way of his lifestyle. So people started so many ways. They started so many types of experiments, so many types of activities about of this earth. They dig so many mines, and also they destroyed forests for their growth, their development. So because all these activities, forest, deforestation also continued. So in these all problems, because of these all problems caused by human only, any animal, any plant or any small insect doesn't involve in this matter. Only human being, they want to better life, they started to this our earth. They was the cause for crisis of our environmental crisis. Human is the reason only. So because of that we faced global warming situation. Because these global warming, you all know about, in some rainy seasons frequently floods occurred. Why these floods occurred? Anybody know about this? We use these natural resources by as our likes. So automatically there are floods also drowned in the surrounding areas of this river, floating areas or streams or tanks or lakes. So that is reason by human. And some human also faced problems about of this crisis. Just like some people, they lost their work, they lost their professions also because of this crisis. For example, in sea coastal areas, fishermen, mostly fishermen lost their lives because of this crisis. Like this, and other animals. Now, once a time in our land, so much area, forest region was there. So many types of animals also lived together on this earth. But now, because of our activities only, some types of animals are no more on the earth. that is only caused by human only. So our human, they wanted to develop theism, they wanted to develop industries, they wanted to develop so many better life, easy life way, but they destroyed the environment. Then now only human think about these problems. So now as all the countries and the world, in the world, they started how to control this global warming, how to protect our mother earth. So many types of activities like forestation, planting of forests, or to develop the social forest regions, and also some other activities. Otherwise, in our future generations, like now our generations also used these all resources, totally these all resources totally completed, and there was no coal in the mines, no iron, no any type of metals, no petrol, no any. After our generations, next generations, how they live on this earth without any these resources, how they develop their, how they live on this earth without industries, without provisions. And because of this global warming, our farming also destroyed. So we use different types of chemical fertilizers and pesticides for our farming. So because of these chemicals, we got so many types of diseases. These are all reason only by this environmental crisis. In our previous classes, in our 7th class and 8th class, we discussed about the different areas, different types of temperated regions on the earth, and also different types of animals, soils, rocks, and so many we discussed already about that. Now we discussed about our universe. This universe means all the space. In this space, the sun, the earth, and so many stars, the moon, and so many particles are the part of this universe. So in this universe, ancient people, they wanted to understand, they wanted to try to understand about this universe. So they know different types of theories. The first people, ancient people, they thought about our earth is not moving. Our earth is in the fixed place. The sun and the moon is only rotating on the earth around the sun. But after this is known as geocentric theory. This geocentric theory means earth-centered theory. Is also introduced by Ptolemy. So ancient people in all over the world, so many areas of the world, they thought about this only. Means earth is in fixed place, the moon, the sun, these both are traveling from one side to another side. And then about of these objects on the space, objects means there are so many stars in the on the space, and so many types of objects that the people wanted to study. So they observed carefully about of these objects, like in every period some eclipse also occurred. These eclipse, solar eclipse, and after 15 days some lunar eclipse. How these eclipse formed? So they started study about of the space. So on that studies, our ancient studies also, our ancient books also about, they explore about these type of studies. For example, on those studies, Vedanga, Jyotisha, Surya Siddhanta, and then Bhagavata Purana. Most important ancient Indian books related to this space. How this space is there? How our earth and this the moon and the sun, the place of these objects. So these are all the studied about this in the books. And then after some these how, for example, earth is in the centered place, the fixed place, how these eclipse formed, how seasons changed from one period to another period. So people also then again studied, again observing about of this only. So then on the way they know about our earth is not in centered place. The sun is in the fixed place, and also sun around itself. And our earth also one of the object to round around the sun. So that is known as sun centered theory by Copernicus. So after this sun centered theory, people all know about how these eclipses are formed, how these seasons changed one period to another period, because our earth is always round itself, that is known as earth's rotation. In the same way, earth also around the sun also, that's called as earth's revolution. Because of these only we have changed this day and the night, and also changed the seasons throughout year. So that is only reason for sun centered theory by Copernicus. The previous, the Ptolemy announced that geocentric theory means earth centered theory. On that period, so much of studies also continuously, so many studies also about of space. But after, because of these objects, because of these things, how these occurred on the earth, how, why this eclipse formed, why the seasons changed, why in some area of the earth became night time and some area became daytime, how these day and night differences formed on the earth. So because of that studies, we know about this earth is not in center place, the sun is in the centered place. That is known as sun-centered theory by Copernicus. And then galaxies. These galaxies, what are called galaxies? Galaxies means the group of stars. So many number of group of stars in the space. That group of stars is known as galaxies. Our solar family means the center part, sun, and the earth is around the sun. This is, and so many some other planets also around the sun. That is called a solar family. Like the solar family, so many solar families also there in the space. So such type of stars. So our sun also one of the star only. Sun also one of the star. Like sun, so many stars means so many suns also there in the universe. So these all stars, and some of the stars are most bigger than our sun, and these stars have also maybe some solar families, and there may be some planets around that stars. But now also our scientists, they observing on the space continuously, so many types of activities done by them. For example, all the countries including our country also wanted to study about the space. And these studies, first human land on the moon also, human land on the moon, and then space capsule land on the Mars, nearest by our earth. So these are because of some types of observation of space. and also some space shuttles also beyond to the solar family, and they are researching about the space also. And now also continuously all the countries wanted to know about more and more information and gathering more and more information about the universe and about our solar family. And also our scientists, you also know about in recently we want to settle another planet, so whether there is the conditions for favorable conditions for life. So this research also, so many scientists also continuously they are in that work only for researches. So this is the solar family. This is our solar family. The universe, in this universe, our sun also one of the part in the universe, and this sun, the earth also another part. Means this earth is round around this sun. Continuously, this is not stop. Earth round itself and also traveling around the sun. Because of that only, we have changed this day and nights and also seasons in the year. And the eclipse also form. And so many types of activities are conducting because of this eclipse. The solar family, our earth rotates its own axis, means rotates round the sun in the particular path only. It's not change its direction, it's not change its the way. So continuously it rotating on this particular axis only. That is a path of orbit. It's a planned orbit. In this, like earth, other planets also in the solar family, other planets also round around the sun of their particular path, particular orbits only. So because only these planets in the space doesn't dash with each other, because they had most systematic rotation, most systematic movement is there. That is, they always round in their particular their orbit only. So this our earth planetary body, earth continuously they round this orbit, that particular orbit, that is plane of orbit. In this type, here are three pictures are there in this blackboard. The first one, circular path. The second one, oval path. The third one, scaled oval path. Anybody know about how our earth around the sun, in these types of paths, in which path earth's movement is around the sun? Anybody know? The first one, this is circular path. For example, our earth is round in the circle shape around the sun. This round is around this path. Now we discuss about our seasons. This type of seasons also may be in different way. In the second one, oval path. This oval path situation also, in some yearly two times, earth very far away from the sun. And in that two times, earth is very nearest to the sun. So in this situation, the weather, the earth is very nearest to the sun, we may got much of temperatures. And for example, it's a very long away, the earth, so the mostly half of the earth became as ice, because a very cold temperature, very minus degrees temperature formed on the earth, and most of the earth maybe became ice. And the third one, scaled oval path. In this moment, in sometimes, mostly in two times of the year, the earth is some most closest to the earth. And the two times, only some small difference from this closest to the largest. So So that is a very quiet difference between the this path. So in this A, B, C, three types of paths, which type of path our earth round the sun? That is the scaled oval path. In this path, yearly two times earth was very closest to the sun, and in two times some far away. So that is the distance of these two types is here are the farthest point is 152 kilometers, 152 million kilometers, and the closest for 147 million kilometers. So our Earth's orbit is like this scaled oval path. This scaled oval path, Earth always round this particular path only. This doesn't move on the other side or lower side. It's only always round in this particular region, particular orbit only. And this rotation, this traveling of this Earth continuously. Earth traveling, it doesn't stop in any time. Always continuously Earth traveling around the sun. So that traveling speed of the Earth is 1,07,200 kilometers per hour. How much? 1,07,200 kilometers per hour. So such type of speed Earth always round the sun about of such type of speed. So because of this one round around the sun is nearly the time is taken nearly 365 1 by 4 days. You know 365 1 by 4 days means 1 year. So our Earth traveling continuously around the sun is the time taken about 1 year. So that because only in this 1 year period we got some seasons. We got so many changes in our atmosphere and some areas when we pick these round, and also another moment also there to the Earth. You know about this, you learned about this in your previous classes. That is Earth's rotation. Earth also rotates itself from west to east. This is also not stopped in any time. Continuously Earth always rotates itself from west to east. That is known as Earth's rotation. With that rotation, Earth also not stopped. It also continuously traveling around the sun. That is known as Earth's revolution. Because of Earth's rotation, we got day and night changes. And because of these revolution, we got different seasons, different types of climatic conditions in different parts of the world because of this Earth revolution only and this. Now we discussed, now we know about how this name of this Earth derived. Who named this as the Earth? So this name was derived from a Greek word Earth. Greek word means Earth. Earth means land, soil, and rocky lands and hard particles on the part of the earth is known as earth. Because of this, derived this from this earth, our earth is known there. And in our language also, in our Telugu language also, there are so many names of this earth. You may know about some names. And also some named their children also about this name, Dhatri, Charitri, Pudami, Bhumi, and so many names are there in our language. So that is the our earth. We are all living on this earth, so that only we know this earth as Mother Earth, because Mother protects us in our house. Just like of that, our earth also always protects us. It also protects all the things, all the aspects, all the human being, all the forest regions, trees, animals, creature, totally earth protect all these total. So earth is known as Mother. So we call that earth Mother Earth. So in this lesson, in this topic, now we know about how our earth is formed, means how, when was our earth formed, and here mostly some millions of years ago earth formed, and then 1 lakh years ago there is a life started on the earth, and then continuously human, because humans are most intelligent persons, most intelligent fellows than other creature, than other animals. So that only human started to searching different objects. They are observing different objects. So they are investigating different objects in the space. How the stars are light. In the daytime, where the sun came from, and the sun gives us light and heat. And in the after some hours, the sun may go and the moon. Okay. How these are all occurred? So that only some humans, some intelligent people, they started studies, they started investigation about of this space. The first one, previous people, they know, they thought about our universe. In our universe, our earth is in fixed place. After all this sun, in the morning sun came, and the evening sun may go, and the moon came. That is only the sun and the moon moving around the earth. Earth is in the fixed place. That is the thought about the ancient people. That's also announced by the Ptolemy, then the earth-centered theory. And then because of studies and then some investigations, people, our Indian ancient astronomers also, they studied about this space. Because earth is in center place, how these eclipses are formed, that is arose by some. So then only they started much and much investigations about this space. And then Copernicus, they announced that earth is not in center place. The sun is in the centered place, and earth and some other planets also around the earth. So this is called as solar family. And this solar family, in some other stars also in the universe, and at night time we see so many stars in the sky. Sun also one of the sky. So he announced that sun also one of the star. In this star, we round around the star only, so we are all in the part of this solar family. And other stars also, some stars are more bigger than our sun, and there also may be some solar families, although there are not. So this investigation also continuously running about the space. And in human, they land on moon also. And some space shuttles also land on Mars, and some they beyond the solar family, they started investigation about this universe. And some recent studies in the frequently in newspapers we know about some these saucers, they round the some persons, and all that we may pick photograph about of such saucers. They are all the people of another planets. Maybe they are the another solar family people, maybe came to our planet. So such type of also continuously run. But it may be the whether the solar saucers are real or not. Now also that our investigation that also continuously investigated by our scientists. So this is the system of our solar family, our moon, our earth. How and the next how the earth was formed. This we discussed about that formation of earth in our next class. Now today we learn about this planetary body, earth particular path of earth plane of orbits and solar system and the orbits, the earth's rotation and earth's revolution and how our earth protects us. And not only now, in our future generations may be also use this earth. So we protect our earth. So we started some protection about these some types of minerals and some types of metals we frequently used, you frequently continuously used about this all. So now human also, now all the countries also wanted to protect our human natural resources, so that they started some activities and they wanted to control global warming. Because of global warming also so many problems arose from the earth. So we wanted to end this. Okay, I think you all understand about my lesson. Now today some evaluation is there. You may answer these questions. The first one is, what is the environmental crisis? You may write down in your notebooks. The second one, what is meant by solar system? The very very easy questions you may easily write in your notebooks. And the third one, why do you think people today curious to know about space? How people curious to know space? So that is only you write in your own words, write your own aspects. And then next, sun-centered theory proposed by whom? Name such person. The last one, Earth's path around the sun is called Earth's path. We discussed about that, and here are some figures also we drawn. Earth's path is called Earth. So you may answer these questions. Okay, thank you.